Hello everyone, welcome you back in this physics video. In today's video we are going to start our new unit. This is the fourth unit, which is electromagnetic induction and alternating current. So in it we are going to start this chapter. Now it is electromagnetic induction. So in short form it is known as EMI. Electromagnetic induction mean to say that by the effect of magnetic we are going to produce this electricity. Okay, so therefore it is known as electromagnetic induction. Now student, in our previous videos of magnetic effect of electric current, we come to know from Oersted experiment that when a current passes through a wire, so it produces magnetic effect, it produces magnetic field. But over here in the year which is around 1830, there were the two scientists, one Michael Faraday who were from England and second Joseph Henry from USA. They performed the experiment to demonstrate that electric current can be produced by changing magnetic field. So here this is the important word that we need to focus. It is changing magnetic field. So when there is a changing magnetic field, so it produces electric current. So this phenomena is known over there, electromagnetic induction. Now on the basis of this concept, our transformer, electric generators, they work. Let us see their experiment. They have considered a closed coil over here. This is a closed coil which is connected with the galvanometer, and near to it a magnet is kept at rest. So there it is, magnet which is at rest. So magnet produces magnetic field. Here that this magnetic field goes out from that north pole and they enters from south. Okay, so this is the magnetic field of a magnet. Now as the magnet is at rest, therefore we observe that this galvanometer which is attached over here, it shows no deflection. So the meaning of this, that there is no current in the circuit. ठीक है, गैल्वेनोमीटर जीरो डिफ्लेक्शन कब शो करता है, जब सर्किट में कोई भी करंट ना हो. सो देयरफॉर व्हेन द मैग्नेट इज एट रेस्ट, सो देयर इज नो करंट इन दिस क्लोज लूप. नाउ इन सेकेंड स्टेप स्टूडेंट, व्हेन वी आर मूविंग दिस मैग्नेट टुवर्ड दैट क्लोज लूप, सो इट इज ऑब्जर्व दैट देयर इज डिफ्लेक्शन शोन बाय अ गैल्वेनोमीटर. सो इट्स पॉइंटर shift toward right, so it is indicating over there is a current which is in this circuit. So galvanometer shows a deflection and that means there is a current in the closed loop. So this current in the closed loop, let me to suppose it that it is in anti-clockwise. We have taken this is the direction of the current. Now why this current has produced in this coil? So the answer of this student, as this magnet comes closer, so therefore the field line which is linked with this closed loop, they start to change. So due to of this changing magnetic field with that closed loop, this current gets produced in this closed circuit. Okay, now that current which is passing in this circuit due to of this changing magnetic field, we are going to call it as induced current. It is induced current. So what is induced current? The current which is produced in the closed circuit due to of changing magnetic field. So we can write it is due to changing magnetic field, magnetic field current produced in circuit. So it is said to be as induced current. Okay, and as all of us we are known that to make the flow of current there must be a potential difference. Okay, so therefore that the potential difference which is generated in the circuit due to of this changing magnetic field which is going to link with this closed surface, we are going to call this as induced EMF. Okay, so induced EMF is that voltage due to of which induced current flows in that closed circuit. So this is the observation over here. What in it we need to focus on this student, that when the magnet north pole is coming closer to the coil, so we have supposed that the current is going in this anti-clockwise. Okay, now let us to move the magnet away from the coil. So here it is, when this magnet is moving away from the coil, again it is observed that this galvanometer shows a deflection. What you will find that when the magnet was coming closer, that time deflection shown, it was toward right by that galvanometer. But over here when this magnet is moving away, so that time galvanometer shows the deflection, but this is toward left side. So it is indicating over here that the direction of the current, induced current which is in the coil, that has reversed. So therefore galvanometer shows deflection, but now in a opposite direction. So indicating current has induced, but direction reversed of this induced current. Now again, why this has happened, why the current induced over here? So again student, what is happening, as the magnet is moving away, so the magnetic field which has linked with this close loop, so they start to decrease. Okay, they start to decrease over there, and due to of it this is the changing magnetic field. There is what, there is the magnetic field is going to change, which is linked with this coil, and due to of this changing magnetic field, induced current gets produced. So that's what it is made earlier important, that consideration of our theory that demonstrated electric current can be produced by changing magnetic field. So changing was the important. So therefore to change the magnetic field, we are going to move this magnet. Now over here in the fourth point, we can observe that we are having a coil through which the current is going to pass due to of the battery. So this battery supplies the current, and due to of this it is going to behave as a solenoid. Okay, so thus we observe over there the magnetic field is produced by this coil. So this coil is named as primary coil. This is primary. Now near to it we are keeping this another coil, so which is connected with this galvanometer. So it is observed that when there is the relative motion in the sense, we can say that either we are moving this secondary coil or either we are moving that primary coil, we are observing over there a current is produced in this secondary coil, because primary produces the magnetic field, and when we does the motion of this secondary coil, so the field line linked with it also changes, and due to the changes of magnetic field, induced current gets produced, which is detected by that galvanometer. So therefore we can say relative motion of current carrying coil and a conducting coil induces current. Now in this method we are taking a coil through to which galvanometer is connected, and in the nearby coil we are connecting a battery. What this time student, we are having a switch. over here. So when switch is closed, so the current will start to flow in the circuit. It means current will increase in the circuit. So when the current will increase in circuit, it will produce magnetic field, and this magnetic field will link with the this nearby coil. But if we are going to turn off this switch, so the current in the circuit, it will decrease, and current decreases, so the magnetic field will also decrease, and that magnetic field will also decrease, which is linked with this nearby coil. So it means, student, that due to on and off of that current in the circuit, changing magnetic field is produced, and that changing magnetic field, when linked with this nearby coil, so it will also induces the current in this, and this is detected by that galvanometer. So thus we got on this conclusion. So from Faraday's and Henry's experiment, we observe that this induced current is produced in a closed circuit whenever there is the changing magnetic field. And second point, there is no induced current if there is no change in magnetic field linked with a closed surface. Okay, so whenever there is a changing magnetic field which is linked with the coil, so that will help to produce this induced current in that circuit. Now let us to learn over here what will be the direction of induced current in that closed loop. So the direction of induced current in this closed loop, when that magnet is coming closer or either when the magnet is going away, so this is given with the help of Lenz's law. Okay, so over here Lenz's law says that when this north pole will come closer to this closed loop, so the current in this closed loop will pass in such a direction so that it will have the same polarity that will repel the magnet from it. So therefore, here how the when north pole is coming closer, so it means this face of that coil, it will behave as north pole. So for north polarity, that the current must be in anti-clockwise. So here it is anti-clockwise. Okay, so this is the direction of the current. तो जब नॉर्थ पोल क्लोजर आता है तो जो नियरर फेस है उस कॉइल का, वो नॉर्थ पोलैरिटी डेवलप कर लेता है. तो नॉर्थ पोलैरिटी हमारे पास उस करंट लूप की कैसे बनती है, जब करंट जो है वो एंटी क्लॉकवाइज में फ्लो करेगा. ठीक है, एंड व्हेन दिस सो इन सिंपल वर्ड वी कैन आल्सो से दैट ये जो नॉर्थ है, नॉर्थ और नॉर्थ के बीच में क्या होगी, रिपल्सन होगी. तो इसलिए हमारे पास यहाँ पर ये जो इंड्यूस करंट है वो क्या कर रहा है, उस मैग्नेट को रिपेल करने की कोशिश. बट दिस मैग्नेट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड हैज़ इंड्यूस इट. तो ये जो मैग्नेट की मैग्नेटिक फील्ड है वो क्या कर रही थी, इस करंट को इंड्यूस कर रही थी. बट दिस इंड्यूस करंट इज ट्राइंग टू अपोज दिस मैग्नेट. और ये जो हमारे पास इंड्यूस करंट है वो इस तरह से फ्लो कर रहा है कि वो इस मैग्नेट को ही रिपेल करने की कोशिश कर रहा है. ठीक है, क्यों, क्योंकि जब ये मैग्नेट क्लोजर आ रहा है तो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा फील्ड यहाँ पर उस क्लोज लूप के साथ लिंक हो रही थी. तो इसलिए ये जो करंट है वो क्या करता है, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड को इनक्रीज होने से रोकता है. इसलिए वो ऐसी डायरेक्शन ले रहा है जो उस मैग्नेट को रिपेल कर रही है, उसको दूर ले जा रही है. Now the second thing over here, when the magnetic this is going away, now again that induced current which is in the circuit, it will flow in such a direction that now it will try to attract this magnet. अब ये क्या करेगा, जो दूर magnet जा रहा है उसको attract करने के लिए यहाँ पर जो current है वो flow करेगा. ठीक है, तो इसलिए हमारे पास यहाँ पर जो करंट की डायरेक्शन होगी दैट मस्ट बी इन सच अ वे दस विल हैव अ साउथ पोलैरिटी, क्योंकि साउथ और नॉर्थ के बीच में क्या होती है अट्रैक्शन। जब क्लोज आ रहा था तो सेम पोलैरिटी डिवेल्प होती है, और जब दूर जा रहा है तो अपोजिट पोलैरिटी। तो अपोजिट पोलैरिटी क्या करेगी, अट्रैक्शन। तो इसलिए जो करंट होगा यहाँ पर इस क्लोज लूप के अंदर वो हमारे पास क्लॉकवाइज होगा, ठीक है। सो दस द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द इंड्यूस करंट इट इज गिवन विद द हेल्प ऑफ लेंजेस लॉ। सो लेंज लॉ व्हाट इट स्टेट्स दैट, तो लेंज लॉ ने बोला कि जो इंड्यूस करंट इस क्लोज सर्किट के अंदर बनता है इट ट्राइज टू अपोज द कॉज विच प्रोड्यूस इट, ठीक है। ये क्या करता है, अपोज करता है, अपोज द कॉज विच प्रोड्यूसिस इट, ओके। सो दिस इज दैट डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंड्यूस करंट। इज सच दैट ओके दैट इज रिटन ओवर हेयर, डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंड्यूस करंट इज सच दैट इट अपोज द कॉज विच प्रोड्यूसिस इट। तो अगर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बढ़ रही है तो ये उसको कम करने के लिए क्या करेगा, सेम पोलैरिटी डेवलप कर लेगा। और यहाँ पर जब ये मैग्नेट दूर जा रहा है तो जो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इस लूप के साथ ही वो कम हो रही थी, तो तब ये जो यहाँ पर पोलैरिटी है वो क्या करती है, उसको अट्रैक्ट करती है, सो दैट इट विल इंक्रीज द करंट ओवर हेयर, ठीक है। सो वी कैन से दैट इफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लिंक्ड विद कॉइल इंक्रीजेस इंड्यूस्ड करंट टेंड्स टू डिक्रीज इट, ठीक है। तो इंड्यूस करंट उसको कम करने की कोशिश करता है। एंड सेकेंड पॉइंट देयर इफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लिंक्ड विद कॉइल डिक्रीजेस सो इंड्यूस्ड करंट टेंड्स टू इंक्रीज, ठीक है। तो उस वक्त जो इंड्यूस करंट है वो उसको इंक्रीज करने की कोशिश करता है, ठीक है। तो इन दिस वे वी कम टू नो कि जो इंड्यूस करंट है वो कौन सी डायरेक्शन लेगा, वो डायरेक्शन जो उसके कॉज को अपोज करता है, ठीक है। तो अगर वो इंक्रीज हो रही है तो वो डिक्रीज करने के लिए डायरेक्शन लेगा, अगर डिक्रीज हो रही है तो इंक्रीज करने के लिए डायरेक्शन लेगा, ठीक है। सो दस क्लोजर फेस जब नॉर्थ आता है तो ये नॉर्थ पोलैरिटी डेवलप कर रहा है, और जब दूर जा रहा था मैग्नेट तो अपोजिट पोलैरिटी उसको अट्रैक्ट करने के लिए, ठीक है। एंड इफ यू विल से ओवर हियर दैट साउथ पोल ऑफ द मैग्नेट कमिंग क्लोजर, तो यहाँ पर साउथ पोलैरिटी डेवलप करता, एंड इफ द साउथ पोल गोज अवे देन इट विल अट्रैक्ट ओवर हेयर विद द हेल्प ऑफ नॉर्थ पोलैरिटी। तो जो करंट है यहाँ पर वो एंटी क्लॉक वाइज में फ्लो करता, जिससे एंड यहाँ पे नॉर्थ पोलैरिटी डेवलप होती, ओके। सो दैट्स ऑल फ्रॉम माय टुडेज वीडियो, थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस।